Hello everybody, my name is PHENG SUON. I hope everything is going well with you. Today I'm coming to resume the Hindu mythology Ramayana, the battle in Sri Lanka between monkeys and demons, summarily, on the north wing of the West Gallery. Long time ago, there was a king named Dasaratha, had three queens. One named Koh Kalayan got a prince named Ram. Two, Queen Sumitra got two princes named Laksmana and Sodhrod. And three, Queen Kakesey got a prince named Pirot. There was an ascetic sage named Pisvamit celebrating a dignity ceremony for Ram and Laksmana after they graduated the great Hindu magical knowledge from the holy scriptures. And there was a demon named Kanasur came to obstruct the event. The great sage used his magic to make a holy bow and arrows and gave them to Prince Ram. And the prince shot the arrow to kill the demon in that time. That was like a test for Ram's power. There was in Kingdom Uttila, the king named Junot had celebrated plowing ceremony from his palace toward down the ocean in order to get a princess, as a sage wished him, while he was praying. When he got there at the beach, he saw a glitter sparkling from the foams floating on the water. The king realized that it must be the princess whom was given from the paradise. The king came down to wed and saw a beautiful princess laying on a great lotus flower. He was so excited and named her Sita. When Sita grew up, her beauty was the most beautiful in the universe. The king Juno announced for the strongest man, whoever could raise the holy bow will get married to Sita. In this recruitment, there were Indra, Brahma, Surya, and Chandra also came to try, but they couldn't raise the bow. And finally, the great sage Pisvamit introduced the prince Ram to try, and the prince could lift the bow with a single hand easily and broke down the bow, provoked a heavenly downpour, and earth was shuddering. The king Juno and his queen dispatched the royal ambassadors to invite the king Dasaratha to participate the wedding ceremony in his palace between Prince Ram and Princess Sita. After the party, King Dasaratha, Ram, Laksmana, and Sage Pisvamit brought Princess Sita to the capital city, Ayodhya. The King Dasaratha, he intended the Prince Ram, who was the eldest and royal heir, to succeed the throne after him, but his third queen, Kakesey, protested and reminded him, while the king was fighting with Surya, the god of sun, he has promised that if the queen Kakesey can help him to defeat the god Surya, he will nominate her prince to succeed the throne. Regarding to this promise, the king Juno wasn't happy, but he must respect. And the queen Kakesey asked him to exile the prince Ram, Laksmana, and Sita on ordination to the jungle for 14 years. For this request, the king got suffered and regretted with what he had done indeed, until finally he got terribly ill. The prince Ram, his brother, and his queen were willing to go to the jungle on Kakesey's request, as well as to help releasing his father's concerns, until they reached Chitrakoot mountain. At Chitrakoot jungle, suddenly the whole atmosphere was changed. The flowers blossomed in the wrong season. All the fierce animals became meek, like tiger's cubs came to suckle breasts of a female impala. and the impala calves came to suckle the female tiger's milk. Not long after that, King Junot diseased, and the queen Kakesey has deceived her prince Pirot that the king is already died, and the prince Ram is succeeded the throne from his father. Please come to celebrate the coronation ceremony of your brother Ram. The prince Pirot, having heard like that, he got delighted. He quickly came out from the jungle to the palace to join the ceremony. But when he got there, everything was not the same as he had expected. He asked the royal servants, "Where has the king Ram gone?" They told the prince Pirot that Ram, Laksman, and Queen Sita have gone on ordination to the jungle already. The prince Pirot, when he heard that, he got very furious with his mother, but the queen Koh Kalayan tried to console him until he cooled down. And the prince, he did not stay in the palace, and he rushed out on barefoot to find the prince Ram to come back and crown the throne. Finally, the prince Pirot found his brother at the bottom of Chitrakoot mountain and told him everything, but the prince Ram, he did not acquire his pleading and saw his brother's foot were bleeding from pricking by thorns and sharp stones. He pitied for his brother very much and promised to him that he will come back. In this dramatic moment, Ram, he took off his shoes and gave them to his brother, hugging him in his chest, and said, "Pirot, please go back to crown the throne, my beloved brother. You must be a good king of Ayutthaya. 14 years is not long at all. I will come back." Having heard his brother, Prince Pirot got very satisfied and left his brother with tearing. The Prince Ram, Laksman, and Sita, they also continued their journey on to Dunakan Mountain near the sea. When they were just getting there, they met a demon named Pirip, and this demon came to snatch Princess Sita. Laksman took task to grab the princess back, but failed. Then Prince Ram shot his holy arrow to kill the demon. Laksman got resented with his ability, and he left to revive and learn more holy magics for a while. The Prince Ram and his Queen Sita staying in a shrine in the jungle peacefully. But one day, there was a female demon named Suvanaka, sister of Ravana, had disguised into a beautiful apsara, came in to woo the Prince Ram, but Ram rejected. And he told her to flirt his brother Laksman. But Laksman, he was still single. When she saw Laksman, she tried to attract the feeling of Laksman, but did not work. He wasn't distracted, and it became the annoyance for him. Laksman prayed her to stop doing that and go away. But she was so persistent. Laksman got angry and pulled his dagger to cut her hair and her nose. She got extremely hurt and shouted loudly, frightened all the beasts in the jungle. The screaming was heard to her brother who ruled the kingdom nearby, named Krongkor. Krongkor came to take revenge for his sister, and at first, Krongkor ordered his two commanders, named Konstuh and Treimuk. They were both killed, and finally Krongkor himself came to fight and still died by the holy arrows of Prince Ram. By seeing all the brothers slay, the female demon Suvanaka flew back to Sri Lanka and told all the story to her brother Ravana, and additionally, she told her brother about the prominent beauty of Sita, the most beautiful girl she has ever seen, in order to propel Ravana to take her to make a wife. Ravana had ordered one of his soldiers named Moharika transforms to a golden deer to deceive the Prince Ram. When the Princess Sita saw the deer,
She asked Ram to kill him for a ladder to pave the floor when they returned to the palace.
The prince left the shrine chasing the deer with bow and arrows. Until he got far enough, the demon cried likely Prince Ram's voice asking for help. Sita heard and got worried about her husband. She asked Laksman to go find Ram. Laksman knew that it is a trick of the demons, but he couldn't protest with Sita and told her not to go out of the holy boundary before he leaving. Ravana took chance to disguise to be a sage, came to get propitiation. Sita finally came out from the holy zone to revere the sage, but the ascetic sage suddenly became a fierce demon, abducts her, flew out to Lanka. The two brothers coming back to the shrine, they did not see Sita, and they knew that there must be a demon has abducted Sita. And they tried to run after the demon, but no trace. Ravana flying on his chariot, taking Sita to his capital. In the sky, there was a big bird named Sidayu, had dedicated his body to serve the Prince Ram. Saw Sita being kidnapped by a demon, he tried to grab her back. But the demon tugged the ring from Sita's finger, her to kill the bird, and the bird fell down to the ground. Ram and Laksman fortunately met the bird on their way, and the bird told them who took Sita and gave the ring to Ram before he passed away. Pause here, talking about the monkey king Bali fought with a buffalo king named Tupi for 6 days and six nights. The monkey killed the buffalo on revenge for his parents. The gods in paradise, satisfied with the victory, and poured the rain to celebrate the monkey's triumph. But the rain water mixed with the black blood of the buffalo became red. The younger brother of Bali, Sugriv, waiting at the tunnel gate anxiously, assumed his brother dead, and he took a big rock to shut down the gate. His brother Bali, coming out and saw the gate closed, he thought that Sugriva killing him to in charge the kingdom Kakanbore. Then he realized that the buffalo horn can break the stone, and he broke the horn to push the rock out. When he got out, he intended to slay his brother, but Sugriva knelt down and pleaded his brother to spare his life, because his brother has killed a lot of lives. The bone of those whom were killed pile like a mountain, so he did not want his brother to kill somebody anymore. And he has pledged with his brother that he will depart from Kakanburai until he die and never return. When Sugriva left from the kingdom, the nephew Hanuman also departed along with him to serve him until they reached a river. At the riverbank, up top of the shrine, where the Prince Ram and Laksman live, the monkeys are resting on a big rock under a tree. That time, Laksman came down to scoop the water, and he heard the screaming sorrowfully up the stream. And when he offered the water to Ram, Ram drank it, it was salty. And he asked Laksman, "Why did you get the sea water for me?" Laksman replied, "Not really, Lord. This is the fresh water from the river that I always scoop every day. It must be from the tears of a great monkey crying over there." Ram, he had holy senses. He could imagine how big sorrow of the monkey got, and he asked his brother to invite the monkeys come to greet him. Both monkeys greeting the Prince Ram and devoting their bodies to serve him for life. After they told the prince about the story that had happened, the Prince Ram and Laksman were very pleased and responded that, "No worry, I will help you to slay your brother, Bali, so you can rule Kakanburai and take the queen Tepi for you." Thank you.
the Prince Ram ordered Sugriva on Lua to get Bali come out. Then the two monkey brothers, they fought each other. The first time, the Prince Ram couldn't recognize which one is Bali because the two monkeys, they had so much similar conditions. The second time, the Prince Ram put the wreath on Sugriva's neck to identify. Then he shot the arrow to kill Bali from the back. Sugriva ascended to the throne. Quickly, he conscripted the monkey soldiers from all over the jungle to rescue Sita. After that, the Prince Ram told Sugriva to select a strong monkey soldier to go to Sri Lanka on stalking the power of the demons, as well as to find Queen Sita. Hanuman was appointed because only him could fly, so Sugriva ordered him to take this mission. Hanuman did not hesitate. He flew forward Sri Lanka and got a bridal ring from Ram in his hand for proofing the Queen Sita, as he is the missionary of Prince Ram, because Sita has never seen him before. When Hanuman got in Sri Lanka, luckily he found Sita under a tree in Asoka Garden. Actually, the mighty of the monkey could bring Sita back crossing the ocean, but Sita resisted to follow Hanuman. She was eager her husband coming to take her by himself to prove how much his love to her. She was waiting here for 10 more months. If cannot see her husband coming, she will suicide herself in this garden. She was very appreciated with Hanuman's effort. Before Hanuman returned to the mainland of Kakanburai, he had destroyed some gardens and some temples in Lanka. One of the Ravana's sons, named Saskoma, chased to catch Hanuman, but the monkey hit to break the chariots and killed Saskoma there. Then he returned. Hanuman told all the stories that he had seen and done in Sri Lanka to Lord Ram. And when the Lord heard that, he was delighted and nominated Hanuman as a great commander called Kompanpik. The Prince Ram ordered Hanuman to seek a great sage named Chumpurit for help in teaching him how to construct the bridge across to Lanka. The sage taught the monkey the holy mantras to engrave on the stones, make them light and float. During construction, the goddess who preserved the ocean, named Mekala, got angry because the noise from dropping the stones was annoying her, and she has ordered the big fishes and dragons to remove the stones away. The Prince Ram saw that moment. He got rage and raised a holy arrow called Agivyas, about to shoot and bless the ocean up. The goddess Mekala, seeing the arrow on and the earth was shuddering, she got terribly frightened and came up to please the Prince Ram and beg for forgiveness. If Lord Ram not to destroy her ocean, she promised that she will help to construct the bridge until finished. When Hanuman throwing the stones onto the ocean, he encountered a beautiful mermaid called Tikmacha, and Hanuman asked her for love. Hanuman and mermaid lived together for a while, and they produced a son named Machanop. Half body to the top was monkey, and to the bottom was fish. The battle in Sri Lanka was exploded fiercely. After the Prince Ram, Laksman with monkey troops crossed the bridge to get in Sri Lanka island. Ravana had sent his factions to defend with the Prince Ram, and most of their soldiers got destroyed in the battlefield. Ravana, he got so angry, but he was an intrepid warrior. In the meanwhile, he came to Asoka Garden in order to execute Sita with his sacred sword. But in that time, there was one commander named Puttaka explained him better not to kill Sita. After that, Ravana ordered his 10 sons, one after another, to fight with the Prince Ram. but all of them were killed also by Ram's arrow. Then he ordered the last commander named Masamat to combat with the Prince Ram, but still not succeed, and he got the same fate as Ravana's sons.
Okay, here is the last battle in Sri Lanka between King Ram and Ravana. And now I would like to show you the picture of the main characters. The picture on the top is King Ram. He's shooting arrow to kill Ravana. And his vehicle is monkey Hanuman. He holding a mountain to throw to kill the demon. And next is the picture of Laksman, the brother of the King Ram. And at last is the picture of Vibhishan. He is the younger brother of Ravana. And in the battle, Vibhishan, he revealed the secrecy of his brother to the King Ram, because the King Ram, even he was not immortal, but he got boon from the god Brahma that he won't die in the daytime and nighttime. Neither god nor demon can kill him. So the King Ram, he could kill him only when the sun setting in the middle between daytime and nighttime. Okay, next, I'm going to show you the picture of Ravana. Let's go. In this battle between monkey troops and demon troops, remarkably, we can see more monkeys kill the demons than the demons kill the monkey. So it means that the monkey soldiers, they were stronger than the demon soldiers. And the picture right here is the king of the demon. He got 10 heads and 20 hands, named Ravana, riding on a huge chariot pulled by two monsters. And on top, there is a big monkey. He is also a king, Sugriva.
Finally, Ravana himself came to lead out the last armies to war with the Prince Ram. One of Ravana's brother, named Vibhishan, came on submission to the Prince Ram, and he was a great astrologist. In this last battle, he told the Prince Ram all the secrecy and the weak points of his brother, Ravana, to Prince Ram. Then the prince killed Ravana when the sun was setting in the midway, neither in daytime nor nighttime. The procession of the battle between two kingdoms spent so long time. And when the Prince Ram rescued Sita after destroying Sri Lanka, it was completely 14 years, and that was timing for them to return back to the capital city, Ayutthaya. Later on, the King Ram crowned the throne after his brother Pirat with good virtues. The populace living under his reign got happiness, harmony, and prosperity from that time onward.
Thank you so much for watching my video. I hope you enjoy with my Hindu legend telling. And please don't forget to track on my next video that will narrate about the battle in Kurukshetra kingdom between Pandava family and Kaurava family of Mahabharata on the south section of the West Gallery. And please click on subscribe, hit the bell, and share to retrieve my next video. Thank you so much.